I do believe that it has become very evident that the oceans play so an important role for the future of the world. It is the main resource of a lot of our food. It absorbs so much of the heat and produces 50% of our oxygen. And the fact that our ocean is our best friend, but can also be our largest enemy if it overpowers the land. And so on islands, it's become clearer what climate change means when oceans start rising above the land. And that has made the message of small islands really reach COP21. It has become so visual, so clear through islands what the effect is of climate change, that we are really now out here being hurt by the large countries. They see it and they understand it, and thank God that the main motivation still for humanity is caring for each other. And so it's not gone unnoticed that large countries understand that climate change is real and that islands are facing already the consequence of it, and that something needs to be done very fast. We believe, and that's also what I've been hearing from my colleague friends in on other islands, that 2%, 2 degrees would be too much, and we will not be able to face the consequences of 2 degrees increase in temperature. So we're really striving for 1.5, and I've been trying together with many other islands to make that point. And within our own context of the Kingdom of the Netherlands, I've seen the Netherlands starting with the EU point, 2% would be enough, 2 degrees would be enough. And I see the Netherlands in our conversations today with the minister saying we're also going to stand for 1.5 degrees. So that's an important turning point. And together with naturally this large benchmark of a certain degree, which is more realistic for the islands to survive, also is naturally commitment to renewables, is commitment to the transition that we all need to make in order to have the kind of societies that are long-term and sustainable. And maybe coming from the Kingdom of the Netherlands is a country that already lives partly under sea level and knows what it takes, knows what the investment is that they made to build all those dikes, to build all those gates. They understand that small islands cannot build those dikes, cannot build those gates. We don't have the resources to do so. That would mean that we all would be drowning. And that is really a compelling reason for the world to act. So I'm very convinced that the world has seen the consequences of global warming and is feeling that this is the right moment to act in order to be in time.